Hi, welcome back to VDA class 6. Let us recall what are the things so far you have covered in last previous 5 VDA classes. In my very first VDA class, I have given introduction part regarding the sequencing. And the remaining VDA classes, I have solved the problems of sequencing which are of different types. Those are N jobs on 2 machines, we started. Again, N jobs on 3 machines, N jobs on 4 machines, and at last, 2 jobs on M machine using graphical method also you have solved. So these are the different types of sequencing problem so far you have discussed in previous video classes. In my today's video class, again you are going to solve one more numerical problem which is of N jobs on single machine. Okay, just listen the problem so far you have discussed in last previous video classes. Those problems are pertaining to more than one machine, nothing but it starts with 2 machines. And also, it may be either with N jobs also. Okay, there you have used Johnson's rule for obtaining your sequence order for a jobs. Okay, you know that the Johnson's rule is only meant for N jobs on 2 machines, and also you have solved with 3 machines and 4 machines. And also, you have come across some of the conditions. What are the conditions you need to follow for converting your 3 or 4 machines into 2 machines? Then, already in those classes, we have converted into 2 machines, then we applied Johnson's rule for obtaining sequence order for a particular jobs. We have done also, and also there in that problems again we have calculated elapsed time and also idle time for a particular machines. See, these are the things we have discussed in last previous video classes. In today's video class, here we are not going to apply any Johnson's rule here, because Johnson's rule is only meant for minimum of 2 machine, but the problem is occurring in this today's class is pertaining to only on single machine. Here there is no Johnson's rule is going to be applied. Instead of that, one more rule going to be applied. Those rule is called priority rules. Here we're going to have so many different priority rules are going to be discussed in today's video class. Okay, as for the given priority rule, you're going to obtain different sequencing order. As for that, you are going to solve the problem. Okay, so let us discuss now what are different types of priority rules you are going to come across and how to obtain using these rules to obtain sequence order for a particular jobs. Okay, see, before going for priority rule, I already discussed what is the definition of sequencing. Once again, I am going to recall that definition of sequencing. The sequencing nothing but it is the process of determining the job order or a job sequence on a particular machines or on a work centers. Okay, already I have discussed the definition. Then we'll go with the definition of priority rule. What are priority rules? These are a set of rules mainly used to obtain job sequence or job order on a particular machines. Okay, next, see, these are some of the priority rules I have listed there. There are so many are there. The most important one I have listed here. Those are first come first served, last come first served, shortest processing time, and last one is earliest due date. Let us start with first come first served. So what the priority rule says here? Nothing but whatever the jobs they are given, the which job have highest priority, based on that I need to go for particular job to processing on particular machine. For example, here, so you have a confusion that which job has to be adapted for performing on a single machine for processing. For example, if you have come across any sequencing problem that to with N jobs on single machine, see, whatever the sequence order they have given, for example, A, B, C, D, in that which is having first order, which is the highest priority order, nothing but which job stands in the first order. For example, A, B, C, D, nothing but A is the first order, highest priority, that is stands on first, that's on in first highest position. For that job, we need to process first on a machine. Next priority you have to give for B, next C, next D. See, this is how the first come, first served priority rule says. Whichever the job stands on the first position, that job has to be performed first on a particular machine. Here particular machine nothing but single machine only. As for the sequence they have given in the problem, same thing, you need to go for processing particular jobs on a machine. Now I have said ABCD. Suppose in problem they have given BCAD, then you need to perform B job for a particular processing. You give first priority for the B, next C, next A and D. See, this is what the priority rule of first come first serve says. Okay, I hope you understood. Next, go for last come first heard. It is deadly opposite to the first come first heard rules. Suppose if they are given A, B, C, D sequence order, in first come first serve, what you have done, which stands on the highest position, which stands on the first, that job will going to go for processing on a machine. But in last come first serve, the job which is at the bottom position, whose order is at the bottom, that we need to perform first on a machine. Nothing but your sequence order will be now changes. A, B, C, D, if you are given, you need to go for D, C, B, A. Job which is stands at the bottom, for that job you need to give priority for performing first on a machine. See, this is what last come first serve rule says. Okay, now you go for next one, shortest processing time. See here, suppose if you think that they have given 4 jobs, just you go for searching which is having minimum processing time. Okay, that particular job you need to select and that job has to perform first on a machine. I hope you understood. Once again, I'm going to repeat. In the shortest processing time priority rule, the job which is having a minimum processing time, that job has to perform first on a machine. Understood? See, this is what the rule says about SPT. Next, earliest due date. What is due date? Nothing but the duration. See, duration will be there. Within the duration, we need to complete that particular job. Okay? That duration is called what? Due date. Okay? Nothing but, suppose example A, B, C, D is there. Okay? For A, the duration will be suppose 2 days. For B, 3 days. For B, C, 1 day. For D, 6 days. In that, which is having shortest due date? C is having only 1 day. That job you need to perform first on a machine. You got the idea or not? Nothing but job which is having less time for finishing. Nothing but the job which is having less time for finishing. That job has to perform first on a machine. This is what EDD rule says. Earliest due date, the job which is having earliest due date, that you need to perform first on a machine, and then afterwards, as for the sequence order, you need to go for that. Okay, see, these are the different common used priority rules for obtaining your job sequence order. Okay, now how to use priority rules? See, before going for solving the problems, first step says that decide which priority rule is to be used first. You have to decide which is the priority rule you are going to be used. Next is what? List all the jobs waiting to be processed with their job timing. Understood or not? First, list all the jobs which are in waiting for the processing with along with their processing time. Next step is says that using priority rule, determine which job has to be highest priority, then second, third and so on. Okay. Once you have the priority rule, then you have to make change regarding, as per the rule, what are the jobs you got priority. First example, ABCD is there now. See, using different rules, which job has got highest priority. First, you have to give for that highest priority. You have to keep it in first position. Then so on for second position, third position and fourth position. See, this is how you have to use priority rules. Okay, first you decide which rule has to be used. Then list all the jobs which are in waiting for processing along with the processing time. Then using priority rule, determine which job has highest priority. Then you list for the first and nothing but you keep it for first position. Then again for second, third and fourth positions. See, this is how you are supposed to use for priority rules. Okay. Now we are going to discuss all the priority rules. How I have got sequence order with the example I am explaining now. Okay. Now, for examples here, job sequencing using first come first serve. Suppose jobs they have been arrived in order A, B, C, D, they have given the problem along with processing times they have given. the processing time they have given in terms of days only. Okay, that is 4 days, 7 days, 3 days, 1 day for every particular job he has given, along with due dates. Nothing but within that date you need to complete. These are called due date. Okay, let us discuss now using first come first serve how to arrange your sequence order. I told first come first serve, the job which is in first position, that is the job we're going to perform on first machine. Here the order is there again ABCD only. Here no need to change here, because as for the sequence order you need to go perform on particular machine. Job ABCD, as for that you have to write a processing time also they have given, that is 4 days for A, 7 days for B, 3 days for C, and D for 1 day. Okay, due date also they have given 5 days. See, within minimum 5 days you need to complete your job A, 10 days for they have given for B, 6 days due date for they have given for C, and 4 days for due date for D. Okay, flow time. What do you mean by flow time here? Okay, flow time nothing but finishing time for a particular job. Okay, you got the idea or not? Flow time nothing but finishing time or end time or end period, I can say. Now you go for job 1. What is the flow time or the finishing time for job A? That is the processing time they have given, that is 4. Obviously after 4 days the job will only comes out from machine, that is A job. After 4 days only the machine, from the machine the A job is going to comes out. That's what similarly what I have done in previous classes. Okay, next for the B. Okay, flow time will be how much now? Because before going for introducing your B job onto a machine, 4 days it has to wait, because still it is processing on, still is processing will be done on job A. Okay, immediately after 4 days the B job will be introducing now. At what duration the B will be comes out from machine now? 4 days of A plus 7 days of B. If you total, if you do it, how many days? 11 days. After 11 days only job B will be comes out from machine. Similarly for C now, okay, 11 days nothing but after 11 days only C will going to processing for processing on machine now. Nothing but 11 days plus its processing days, how much? 3 days. Total 14 days is required for C machines to perform its work and complete from machine. Okay, now D. Now what is the finishing days required? Already see here, after 14 days only the D will going to be introducing for machine for performing now. And what is the processing time for D? 1. Nothing but 14 plus 1 is equal to 15. Nothing but after 15 days only D job will going to be comes out from machine. See, these are all called what? Flow time. Flow time nothing but finishing time for the particular jobs. For A it is required 4 days, for B it requires 11 days, because before 4 days I cannot introduce my B job into a machine because it is still processing. Okay, nothing but 4 plus along with processing day for B is 7. 4 plus 7 is equal to 11 days. After 11 days only the B is going to be comes out from machine. Similarly for C. See, after 11 days only I need to introduce my C job onto machine. Okay, now nothing but its processing days are 3 days. 11 plus 3 is equal to 14. Nothing but after 14 days only it will comes out from machine. How many days required for coming out of D from machine is 15 days, because until 14 days I cannot introduce my D job onto a machine. Okay, its processing day is how much? How many days? 1 day. 14 plus 1 is equal to 15 days. See, these are called flow time periods for a particular jobs. Let my next column I have done there, late by number of days, nothing but how many days are delayed by particular jobs with to due date. Okay, let us discuss now. For example, see here, due date they have given particular job is 5 days, but our A job is completed within 4 days only. 1 day before it has completed, late by, there is no late here, because that's why I have written 0 for that. Next, go for B job. Due date they have given for 10 days, but my completed period is 11 days. Nothing but how many days it is late by? 1 day. That's what I have written here. Next, for C job, they have given due date is 6 days, but it has taken 14 days to complete. Nothing but 14 minus 6 is equal to 8 days. It is late by 8 days. Similarly for D job, they have given 4 days for processing, so due date, but it has comes out from after 15 days. Now 15 minus 4 is equal to 11. It is late by 11 days. See, these are called late by number of days. Now sometimes they are going to ask in exam average job flow time, nothing but what are the flow time you got. Now see, now from the particular problem I got flow times are 4, 11, 14, 15 divided by average. How many jobs are 4? If you do it, 11 days. These are the average flow time for the jobs. Okay, similarly for average lateness, nothing but already you see last column you have done late by number of days for particular jobs. For job there is no late days. So similarly for B, C, D have, that is 1, 8, 11 divided by again average. If you take it, anything but 5 days, nothing but for each and if you take average for that, as for all the jobs it is late by 5 days. Okay, see, this is how you are going to solve in if they are given in the problems. See, this is the sequence order you got as for first come first serve schedule. Next go for, now it is going to change now because last come first serve, last come first serve. Here the jobs which is at the bottom order, the priority will be which is having less priority, most least priority, that job has to perform first. The job order they have given, the problem is ABCD. Now you have to go for DCBA. That's the rule says in last come first serve. Okay, again as for that processing time here, for D, how much they have given processing time? 1 day, so C, 3 days, B, 7, and A, 4 days. That's why I listed out. On due date also they have given, as for that you need to take, for D is 4, for C is 6, that's what I have written from the, as for the problem they have given. Okay, now again, same time, flow time nothing, finishing time now. Okay, for D, processing day is given 1, that is 1 I have written. For C is now how many days required for comes out from machine now? 1 plus its processing day. 1 plus 3 is equal to 4 days. Similarly for B is how many? After 4 days only, I need to assign my B job to machine. Okay. 4 plus 7 is equal to now 11 days. After 11 days only, my B jobs will comes out from machine. Now A job. Okay, after 11 days only, I need to allot my A job to machine. Now, there 11 days you have to wait. 11 plus 4 equal to 15 days. Just you observe here, late by number of days here. Okay, flow time and due date here. My job for D job, due date is there again for 4 days. But flow time, it is going to complete within 1 day. There is no late by, that will be 0 I am going to take as for, but I have not written here. For C job, 6 days they have given due date, but it has completed in within 6 days only. Number of late days will be 0 again. Just to observe B and A, again we are going to have late by number of days. That's why I have written jobs B and A going to be late. Understood or not? I have written now. See here, B job has to be completed within 10 days, but it was late by 1 day. The thing about 11 minus 10 is called 1 day. Similarly, A has to complete within 5 days, but it has taken 15 days. Nothing but 15 minus 5 is equal to 10 days. It was late by 10 days. Nothing but here in this problem, B and A are going to be late. Okay. So this is the rule you are going to use whenever the problem is given in. If you have asked priority rule of last come first serve. Okay. Then you go for next priority rule, that is shortest processing time now. Now here, as just you go to the main problem here. So SPT, shortest processing time, says that in that which is having a minimum processing time, or here in this problem they are given in terms of days, which is having minimum days to for processing, that job is to perform first on machine here. Just you observe your table, which D has to only 1 day for, 1 day for processing, that you need to perform first. Second is C now, because 3 days. Next is A, next is B now. My sequence order will be now DCAB. As for the SPT rule, you have to go for which is having minimum processing time or minimum days will be there for processing, that job has to perform first. Here as for that, I have a job sequence of DCAB. DCAB, okay. As for that, you need to time, processing time is here days, in terms of days you have given 1, 3, 4, 7 as for that I have given. Again due date will be as for that you need to take here. Okay, due date for here again 4, 6, okay, 5, 10. I have done same thing here 4, 6, 5, 10. Again, float and finishing time for day. After one day, it is going to complete. That's what I have written one day. But the finishing day is also one day. Next, for C, how many days is required that will going to comes out from machine? One day it has to wait because D is processing on that day. 1 plus and processing day of C is equal to how many days? 3. 1 plus 3 is equal to 4 days. After 4 days only, the C algorithm comes out from machine now. Okay. A. After 4th day only, the A job is to allot for machine now. Because before 3 or before 5 cannot go. Because still it is processing on, C algorithm to processing on machine. After 4 days only, I need to allot my A job to machine now. That is 4. And its processing days are how many days? 4 days. 4 plus 4 is equal to 8 days. After 8 days only, A will going to comes out from machine. Now, last job here as for SPT rule is B. Okay. After 8 days only, I need to allot my B job to particular machine. And how many processing days it is required now? B. 7 days will going to processing on machine along with 8. 8 plus 7 is equal to 15 days are required to required for B jobs to come out from machine. Okay, now discuss again here number of late by number of days here. Due date for D is what they are given 4. It is completed in one day. Okay, there is no late days here. Similar for a C, due date is given is 6. It is going to complete it within 4 days. Nothing but less than 6. There is no late days. Next you go for A, they are given 5 days due date, but it is going to complete in 8 day. It is late by 3 days. Okay, by go for next B, they are given 10 days for due date, but it is going to complete after 15 days. Nothing but it is late by 15 minus 10, nothing but 5 days. That's what I have given here. AB jobs are going to be late. Okay, so this is what I am going to perform my shortest processing time rule for obtaining sequence order. Last one is earliest due date. How to obtain my sequence order for using this priority rule? Earliest due date. For this rule, just you need to go for due date here. Already they have given due dates here. As for that, you need to go. In this due date, see in this problem, which job has minimum due dates here? Obviously D. Only 4 days they have given. Next is what? A. Next is what? C. Next is B. As for that, you know, minimum is what now? D. I need to give first preference for D. That job is going to perform first on machine. Next is what now? A. Third one is C. Last one is B. Now my sequence order will be now D, A, C. D, A, C, B. Okay. This is a sequence order I got. This is the sequence order I got only due to, as for the earliest due date, the whichever job is having minimum processing days here. That's what I have written. D. Processing time is for D is how much? As for if you go for original table, one day. As for that, I have written. And also due date also I have written here. As for that. Okay. Now, flow time for D is how much? As usually, it is going to finish in after one day. Next, for A machine. For A is how much now? For A, you are going to be introducing into a machine only after one day. And its processing days, how many days? 4 days. 1 plus 4 is equal to 5 days. After 5 days only, my A job is going to come from machine. Comes out from machine. Similarly, C job. After 5 days only, the C is going to be entering for machine to perform. Till that, it will be wait. Nothing but 5 plus. Its processing days, how many are there? How many days are there? 3 days. 5 plus 3 is equal to 8 days. After 8 days only, job B has to go for machine. Okay, and its processing days are 7. 8 plus 7 is equal to 15 days. Nothing but after 15 days only, my job B is going to come out of machine. As for earliest due date rule. Okay, here just to observe here, number of days will be laid by D. Obviously, they are given due date is 4 days, but it has completed in 1 day only. And A, exactly as for that due date, it has completed. Now you go for C, 6 days they have given due date, but it has completed on 8th day. Similarly, you go for B, it has asked you to complete within 10 days, but it has completed in 15 days. Here, as for EDD rule, job C and B will going to be late by certain days. See, this is a different types of, we have discussed. Now you have understood how to frame my sequence order as for different priority rules. In last previous examination, they asked this type of problem along with using SPT rule. They ask you to find out some of the conditions here. That's why I have given all the priority rules. If they ask any one of that, you are able to do it now. Okay. Last year they asked SPT rule for obtaining sequence order. Okay. Now let us solve now. See, this is the exact this type of problem they asked in last year examination. Okay. Let us solve this problem. It is very easy problem. Okay. 6 jobs P, Q, R, S, T, U have been received by a manufacturing facility to be processed on a single machine. Okay. The processing times have been given as follows. Okay. Nothing but here total 6 jobs are there. These 6 jobs has to perform on a single machine, and they have given their processing times in terms of minutes they have given. Here the question they have asked is optimal sequence order as per SPT rule. They are here. They are the priority rules they have asked is SPT, nothing but shortest processing time. As for that, you need to go for arranging your order of jobs. Next is flow time, just now I told, or completion time of jobs, mean flow time, and average in process inventory. Just list out the jobs, what they are given along with processing time. Jobs they are given sequence order P, Q, R, S, T, U, and processing they are given 7, 6, 8, 4, 3, 5 respectively. They are given for the respective jobs. Now you have to pick up now. As for shorter processing time, they have given mentioned. If they are not mentioned, means as for as you wish, you select any one of Pareto rule and you mention and you arrange the sequence order for the jobs. Now here directly they are given as for shortest processing time. Now as for that, I need to select my sequence order for the jobs. Among this, which is having minimum processing time, that is T job, only for 3 minutes he has given processing time in terms of minutes he has given. Similarly, go for after three, which one is fourth, which job, that is yes. Next one is again 5 minutes for U job, and again 6 minutes for Q, and again 7 minutes for P, and last one is 8 minutes for R. So this is how, as for the shortest processing time, now you need to change your job sequence as again P, Q, R, S into your own what you have got as for the SPT rule. Now just you go and I have changed now. Now jobs order will be T, S, U, Q, P, R. Now job sequence order will vary in as for the shortest processing time. I have made the columns here, jobs and processing time. That is processing time as for the given, as for the particular jobs, you need to write down now 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, that will going to come out. Now, this is the first question they have asked. Optimum sequence order as for the SPT rule you have made now. The first question is completed now. Go for next one. What is the next one? Flow time or completion time for the jobs. Okay. Just now you discussed in previous slides. Again, we are going to discuss as for the problem now. Flow time or completion time for the jobs now. T job, here the processing, how much here? T job will going to processing on machine only for 3 minutes. After 3 minutes, it going to comes out. That is flow time. The completion period is how much? 3 minutes only. Okay. After 3 minutes only, my S job has to enter now. Yes or no? Nothing but 3 plus its processing time on machine is how many minutes? 4 machine. 3 plus 4 is equal to 7 minutes. After 7 minutes only, it is going to comes out. S job will come out from machine. After 7 minutes only, it is going to complete. Okay. Next, U job. Go for U now. For U job, how many minutes are required to comes out from machine? Okay. After 7 minutes only, my U job will going to enter information. Okay. 7 plus its processing time is how much? 5. 7 plus 5 is equal to 12 minutes. After 12 minutes only, my U job is going to be complete or comes out from machine. Next, Q job. After 12 minutes only, my Q job is able to entering for machine to perform. And they are going to performing how many minutes? 6 minutes. Now 12 plus 6 is equal to 18 minutes is required to complete its operation on particular machine. Now P job is going to be entering into a machine only after 18 minutes. Now 18 plus its processing time, now 7. 18 plus 7 is equal to 25 minutes. Okay. Now R. our machine is going to enter into particular machine only after 25 minutes. Now 25 plus it's processing how much? 8. 25 plus 8 is equal to 33 minutes. After 33 minutes only R is going to be complete its processing on particular machine. Okay. Now next question. This is the second question they asked, completed. Mean flow time. That is, what are the flow time you got? You take, you have to take average for that. That is what mean flow time means. 3, 7, 12, 18 plus 25 plus 33 divided by how many jobs are there? 6 jobs. If you do it, you are going to get 16.33 minutes. Nothing but this is the average it will going to takes for jobs to complete on a particular machine. Average of how much? 16 minutes. After 16 minutes, one job going to be comes out from machine on an average if you take for mean flow time. Okay. Next, last question what they asked here. Average in process inventory. This is very much important. This is the question they have asked in last previous examination. Average in process inventory. It is just now, just you observe here. Yeah, just you see processing time, and again I have made column here 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. I have written there, just you observe those two column now. See, during first minute, nothing but during, see how many units are requiring now. If you are processing with 1 minute, during processing your each minute, how many jobs are left over there, that you need to write. During processing first minute, how many jobs are left over there? 6 jobs, because during each minute, first minute I am telling you, I have not completed 3 minutes. First minute, during processing first minute, how many jobs are left over? 6 jobs, because not even a single job is comes out now. That's what I have written for first. Next, go for next S. Okay, see, after 3 minutes, during performing your S job, then left over is what? 5 jobs. Yes or no? During first minute, understood? Nothing but during processing of your T, 6 jobs are, obviously 6 jobs are going to be processed, nothing but left over. During, after 3 minutes, during processing of 4 minutes, the already one job is completed. During processing of 4 minutes, that is, left over is 5 jobs now. During processing 5 minutes, how many jobs are left over now? 4, because during performing 5th minute, the 4th minute and 3rd minute job is completed now. Left over is how much? 4. During processing time of 6 minutes, leftover jobs are 3 now. Similarly, for during 7th minute, only leftover is 2. During 8th minute, only 1 is leftover. Are getting or not? One second, I am going to repeat. During machining of 3 minutes, during machining of T job, how many jobs are leftover? 6 jobs are leftover. During performing or operation of S, how many jobs are leftover? 5 jobs, because including that, the T is already finished now. During processing of U job on particular machine, fifth minute, 2 jobs are already completed. Remaining is leftover is what? Including that, 4 jobs. During performing Q job, how many jobs are completed? And how many jobs left over? 3 is completed, 3 is left over here. During performing P job on machine processing, the leftover is how much? 2. 4 jobs are already completed. During performing Rth job on machine, the leftover is it's only left with that job only. Okay, see, this is how you have to list out now. Okay, now how to calculate average in process inventory? Now you have a formula that the processing time of particular job with, during that processing time, how many jobs are left over, you need to multiply. Now here processing time for D is what? 3 into 6 plus during processing time, during processing rest job, the leftover, say leftover jobs will be 5, and processing time of S job will be 4. Nothing but 4 into 5 plus. Similarly, during U job, processing U job, the leftover jobs are 4 and its processing time is 5. 5 into 4 plus. Again, during processing Q job, leftover jobs are 3 into its processing time, 6 into 3 plus. During performing P job, okay, leftover jobs are 2, along with processing time is 7, 72 plus. During performing Rth job, leftover is only 1, that's that particular job only, 8 into 2 divided by all, divided by total of all processing time of particular jobs. Something 3 plus 4 plus 5 plus 6 plus 7 plus 8. Understood or not? Once again, I'll tell you, During performing, you have to take average in processing inventory. This can be calculated by multiplying your processing time into leftover jobs during that particular job. Nothing but during performing T job, the processing time is 6 and leftover jobs are including, that is 6. 3 into 6. Similarly, during performing S job, the leftover is how much? 5 jobs, and its processing time is 4. 4 into 5. Plus, you need to, product should be done along with, you need to be add all the jobs. During youth job, 4 jobs are left over. Its processing time is now 5. 5 into 4, you have to need. Plus, during youth job is due performing, 3 jobs are left over. Its processing time is 6. 6 into 3. Plus, again during performing P job, leftover jobs are 2. Along with processing time is 7. 7 into 2. Along with during performing R job, the leftover job is 1. That is what R job only into 8. Processing time is 8. Divided by, you need to add all the processing time. If you do it, total it become 98 divided by 33. Okay, if you do it, you're going to get approximately 3 jobs. Nothing but 3 jobs going to be in order, nothing but you are in sequence, either it may be finished or completed, has to be finished. See, this is how we need to calculate average in process inventory. The minimum of 3 jobs in going to be yet to finished or completed. Okay, this is how we need to calculate average in processing inventory. See, this is the problem they have asked in last year previous question paper. Okay, as for that, I have created example and I have solved the problem. Okay, I hope you understood. This is the easy topic and easy problem they have asked for 6 marks in last year examination. Okay, see, if you have doubt regarding anything sequencing problem, because this is my end of my video regarding sequencing. Okay, and I'll going to come up with next video classes regarding next chapter regarding particular or subject. Okay, if you have any doubt regarding the, just you comment on Google Classroom, so that I'll going to rectify, and again I'll going to tell in next video class. Okay, thank you.